Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk about Tensorflow Lite and how to use Tensorflow in a constrained environment. And in this case I'm talking about Android and how to run your models on a phone. And I'm not talking about training models or anything like that. We need to have a pre-trained model that we have run on some good GPUs or some CPUs and so on. So we have the data ready or already, but we want to have a use case on our phone where we will predict something, or we will try to understand the world around us using TensorFlow models. So there's a very nifty and interesting demo that they have in the TensorFlow framework that you just can download. You can do a git clone or download the zip file from GitHub and install it wherever you have your workspace. And when you have done that, you need to install the latest Android Studio. And if you do any Android development, you should already have this installed. And then inside of your Android Studio, you just import this project and it will be inside of the TensorFlow GitHub repository under contrib lite java demo. And you import that project into Android Studio. And after that, you will download the TensorFlow Lite mobile net model here. And after you have downloaded that, you will put that into your TensorFlow contrib lite java demo. And in the application that you have imported, you go under app, source, main, and assets. And there you put this TF Lite model. So this is the trained model that you download. And they didn't put it in the Git repository because it's a little bit larger and checking in this resource would make no sense. And then just build it in Android Studio, they say. Well, that's not completely true. When I imported in Android Studio, I had to do some small changes to my Gradle file. So I open the Gradle file and here it says 2601, and I didn't have that build version. I had 2703, and whatever build version you have, you just change the build version for your build tools so the current version is in your Android Studio. Either that or you install this 26.0.0. Not something that I wanted to do. I didn't want to have different build tools. I'm doing Android development at the moment and I'm quite satisfied with having one of those. And when you have imported this, you will get a project. And there's a few views, and it will add a bunch of libraries and so on that does the actual TensorFlow recognition. So yeah, if we look in this Gradle file again, we have all the usual suspects to build the GUI, and then you have this TensorFlow org, TensorFlow Lite, and just the latest version. So it will compile that into your project as well in order to run this. And if we look at the code, we have first one file here called autofit texture view, and it's just something that will change the aspect ratio so it will fit your phone the best, so you get the correct height and width and the correct aspect ratio for the picture that you want to gather and do your predictions on. So this is not that interesting. Then we have this camera activity. It's also very small activity frame here, just adding the basic frame for the camera. So nothing interesting here. And the basic frame, here we have the actual logic, and this is a lot of code, so I will not dive into every piece of this code because that will be quite boring. It has some texture, surface texture listener it sets up here, and just overwrite some functions. It has some state callback for the camera device, where it will actually keep the state of the camera in a good order. So that's just some camera fiddling. And if you have worked with cameras and streaming camera data before, this is nothing new for you. And then we have some capture progression and completion, and these are just overridden and not used at all. So this is just something that you need in order to capture data from the camera. And then we have this choose optimal size, and it will figure out the optimal size of your viewport for your recognition. And there's a lot of functions here. Set up camera output. Just look into the code if you want some more information about all the different things that are based for the camera. But a bit further down here, need to find it again, we have a little thing for the actual prediction. So down here we have the classifies frame for a preview stream. So this will actually take some bitmap from the texture view. So the texture view is where you present the data from the camera. So the camera will show something and put it inside of a texture view, and you get the bitmap of that texture view, and you send that bitmap to the classify frame, and then you recycle the bitmap and show a toast with the text that you got from the classification. And if we look at the classify frame, it's inside of a runnable that is run periodically, and it's this background handler that is set up to handle when to run this. So this is a looper that will run at a handle thread name. See here if I can find the actual periodically how often it will run. There was a constant for that somewhere here. It's not that important. It will run quite often, and as there is new data to handle in the camera, it will classify a new frame and it will send it to image classifier. So if we look at the image classifier, the last class that we will go through, and also the last class in this package, it's a very simple class, I would say. It has this TensorFlow lite, this interpreter from the TensorFlow lite library, and this interpreter will load the model file, so it has that. And then we have another function to load the actual label list, so we have a list of labels, and that's just a bunch of strings in an ordered manner, so that we know that if we got something for the number 4, for instance, it's this label that actually got the prediction right, and how much it was predicted it for that label. And so when we have loaded all this, the classifier is ready. So we will classify a frame, and in this we will convert the bitmap into a byte buffer, because the byte buffer is something that we can send to TensorFlow, and then it will just take the bitmap, read all the image data into a byte buffer that they call image data, and then it will send the image data and a label prob array. So that's the probability of the actual label for the TensorFlow Lite response. So this will be filled with the response from the TensorFlow Lite, and then it prints how much time it actually spent to run interference, and then it will apply some filter for the results. So it actually takes the probabilities and does some mangling with the data, so it doesn't the result isn't that sharp. We will do some print k-tops levels. So this is a number of labels that it predicted and how good of a prediction it actually did for those. So if we look at this print k labels, it will go through the labels and then add a sorted list of these labels with the probability of the actual result, and then it will fetch a few of those and put that into a text show string. So this is pretty much everything you need to do. So if you have an already good implemented model, or already a model that have predicted a bunch of stuff, you only need to read in the data and add that data to your TensorFlow Lite model or the TensorFlow Lite library. Run your TensorFlow Lite over a byte buffer from your image and you will get some probabilities back, and then you have to interpret your result that these probabilities are actually for these labels. And a probability is somewhere between 1 and 0. So if it's a 1, it's totally sure that it has found this object. And if it's a 0, it's not sure at all if it has found anything. So let's say that it sees a ball and it says that it's 0.9. Then it's pretty sure that this is a ball. And I will show you a little demo now how this app looks when you actually have compiled and run it on your phone.
Well, lastly, I just want to show this little app in action. So when you have compiled the application, you will get something like this, and it will look at your surrounding in the background, and you might not see it down here, but you can actually see some numbers, what it thinks things are, and also how likely that it have found the right thing. So if it's 1.00, it has found a perfect match, but if it's less than that, it's not that confident of the match. So this is the application.
Thank you for looking at this short video introducing you into the TensorFlow Lite library. There's a lot more to say on this subject, but I hope that you learned something today and that you got inspired to look further into this code and figure out how you can apply this in your workload and your workday. And if you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And if you have any comments or if you have any questions, please ask them down below. And I really hope to see you in the next video.